please not do anything awful for 5 seconds?
Wow!
Well, Miyuki, I'm fairly certain we'd be happy to accommodate you as long as the cat does all the editing and such.
Hi, welcome to Comedy Parenting Radio, the show that's almost imperceptibly stupid.
Almost. Kind of need a magnifying glass to see it.
Oh, looks like Elijah has a healthy little drink over there. What are you drinking, Elijah?
Pure ethanol.
You know, reading fan mail is one of our greatest joys here on the show, and so we're going to be doing a little bit of that today. Stay tuned, and we'll open up some letters from our fans, and you can see what they're saying about Comedy Parenting Radio.
This is my favorite part.
I can't wait.
Speak up, because you can. Your mind is a powerful tool, and so is your freedom of speech. So use it. It's what separates you from being a number to being an individual. Thoughts,
beliefs,
opinions, creativity. It's what makes you,
you.
Stand proud and say aloud. Know your rights. Know your freedom to speak. This message is brought to you by the National Association of Broadcasters, Education Foundation, and the Broadcast Education Association.
This is Habs Johnson.
This is Yuri Komkov.
This is Shirley.
And you're listening to Comedy Parenting Radio.
I don't know about that, Shirley.
Okay, we're back with Comedy Parenting Radio fan mail. Joshua has one from somewhere in Ohio. Josh, what's the name of the person who sent that fan mail?
Johann Schmidt. Dear Comedy Parenting Radio, we received the toaster in the mail. After we shook the crumbs out of it, we put in our first piece of bread. It caught on fire. After we refilled our fire extinguishers, we lowered the setting and tried again. This time on 1. But it still caught on fire.
Was that the toaster in the reject pile?
That was the one that I've been cooking with this whole time.
Why did we send them that one? We were supposed to send them a new one.
We said autographed toaster, and yeah. That was the only autographed toaster we had.
Well, I guess it's the only toaster we had.
If it's good enough for us, it ought to be good enough for them.
Continuing with the letter, they say, please don't send any more gifts. We can't afford any more hospital bills, as Jürgen was sent there with third-degree burns. Respectfully, don't ever contact us again. The Schmidts.
Okay. Next fan mail. Josiah, why don't you read this one here?
Dear Comedy Parenting Radio, we think your show would be 10 times better if it was dead air. Sincerely, a fan.
Oh, look at this one, and it's in a pretty pink little envelope. I want to read this one.
Wow, I like that. Look at that.
I don't want to read that one.
It is from Miyuki Beifong. Oh, it's such a cute name. Hello, Comedy Parenting Radio. What happened to the cat? I would appreciate more radio about the cat. In fact, more cat, less cast. Actually, change that. Just cat, please. Thank you.
Well, Miyuki, I'm fairly certain we'd be happy to accommodate you as long as the cat does all the editing and such. I mean, really?
We have careers to think about here. What's going on?
Yeah.
Who knew that our cat would be a career cat?
Well, I mean, Whiskers could jump far.
Well, that would just be a catastrophe. Hey, this is, I think I'll read this one right here.
Okay, your turn.
I've been waiting all day for this one.
All right.
Dear Comedy Parenting Radio, I accidentally found you online a week or two ago, and since then, my whole life has gone to shambles. Your show is the worst thing that has ever happened to me since the time that I served hot dog water and beans at my wedding rehearsal.
I wonder if he followed Roy's recipe.
I have some pretty good hot dog, water, and bean recipes for wedding rehearsals.
Why is Roy always just sitting in the corner on the couch?
Oh, Okay, that was kind of interesting fan mail. Check this one out. It's a big, long letter.
Ooh, must be interesting.
Dear sir. Ooh, he's calling me sir. I really enjoy listening to your show. I do it all the time, at work, at home, at play. Wow.
That's what we like to hear.
Love that, you know. You have insightful information, guests, and you're really, really funny. That's what we're going for, isn't it? I tell lots and lots of people about your show. You're very, very popular in the circles that I run in.
Wow.
I mean, I've run in some squares, and I have never seen anyone who appreciates our show.
Me neither.
Needless to say, I will be a fan of yours for a really, really long time.
Aw, that's so sweet.
It took me a long time to work up the nerve to write to someone so famous as you, and I will always be a fan of the Joe Rogan podcast. You are the best.
Anybody here named Joe Rogan?
Cut the microphones, quick.
Wait a minute. This fan mail was supposed to go to Joe Rogan.
Why does it have our address then?
Who's Joe?
Rogan.
Yeah, seriously.
Hey, Elijah, I just wanted to tell you, I actually run the Joe Rogan show. I need to go put it in the other mail slot.
Hey, Dad, can you give me that?
Sure.
I'll give it to Joe. How can you?
Ranger Station.
Hi, I want to report a bear sighting.
Location?
My front door. It was Smokey Bear. My husband was burning leaves in the yard. He just came inside for a second.
Never leave a fire unattended. If it's too hot to touch, it's too hot to leave.
Smokey said that too.
We go way back. I knew him when he was just a cub.
How cute.
If you see someone in danger of starting a wildfire, step in and make a difference. Brought to you by Smokey Bear, the U.S. Forest Service, your state forester, and the Ad Council. Learn more at SmokeyBear.com.
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Comedy Parenting Radio, vetoed number one by Parents Magazine.
That's voted number one. Voted number one by Parents Magazine.
No, look, look, look. The article says vetoed number one.
Oh, never mind.
He was trying to thread it on there when the fire fell off of his cigar and dropped on down, sort of rolled around, and lit in the cuff of Earl's pants and burned a hole in his sock. Yeah, sort of set him right on fire. I looked on out of the window and I started counting phone poles going by at the rate of 4 to the 7th power. Well, I put 2 and 2 together and added 12 and carried 5. I'm up with 22,000 telephone poles an hour.
Hey, Joshua, what's this one? Do you want to read it?
Yeah, I'd love to read it.
I'm feeling very lucky on this one.
It was even wrapped in a little gold seal with some gold laces around it.
They must think highly of us.
They must.
Dear friend, I have come to contact you because I do not know who else to contact. I am in dire need of life and services, and I have many monies to which I can help and get to you and things.
Wait a minute. What kind of fan mail is this?
I don't know, but it sounds serious.
Keep going. They probably need our help.
Sounds good to me.
This sounds like a really good idea for a radio theater.
I am a rich Nigerian dignitary escaping from Nigeria to America with my family.
I didn't know we had fans in Nigeria.
I didn't know we had fans. I will be happy to give you money to the sum of $500,000 when I arrive in America if you will just help me by paying for my plane ticket. All I need is your credit card number, your name, the expiration number, and the 3 wacky numbers on the back.
Wait, how much money did we get from this guy?
$5,000?
Go back! It's a trap!
Well, this sounds like a promising deal. I might want to get in on this.
But you don't have a credit card.
Dad, can I use the company card?
Just set this letter over to the side, okay? Till later.
Alrighty.
Thanks.
Huh. This envelope has no return address. Interesting. Well, let me see what's inside. Dear Comedy Parenting Radio, thanks. Sincerely, Generalson Rold Hastapapanopoulos.
Did somebody do something for Hapapapalopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopadopad
If he had a name as memorable as that, I doubt I would have forgotten him.
If I had known this Hepalepacopolis...
Is he one of our guests that we accidentally forgot at that theme park last week?
Here, let me read this one, please. Dear Comedy Parenting Radio, I don't normally write to losers. However, I thought you could use some encouragement. You guys seem to be trying really hard. Occasionally, there's a rare attempt at humor.
Boy, this is a great letter so far.
I like the picture of the rubber chicken, but not the kid with it. After being one ahead of you on the podcast show listings for the last 4 years, I thought you could use some of my advice. Quit while you're behind. Wow. Nonetheless, best wishes. Sincerely, a better person. Okay, that was a great fan mail.
Oh, hey, look at this one. It's got our county official seal on it. Let's see what it has to say. I didn't know the county listened to our podcast. Dear Bigley family, this is the official cease and desist order from our county to your lousy show. Please stop. Birds are falling from the sky, cement trucks are spinning the wrong direction, and the milk is curdling because of your show. Well, this letter can't stop because I don't drive cement trucks, so I'm just gonna go put it into file 13 real quick.
Good idea.
Oh, here's a neat little package. Let me open it up.
What does it say?
It's an envelope with a little origami fan.
Huh, fan mail. Who'd have thunk?
Here's a letter from Hoa.
Hoa? Who?
Hoa.
Who?
Hoa.
No, ah. Who's the health district thing?
Give me that.
Boy, when you give it to him, you give it to him.
That's what
flying
you get
across the room.
That's H-O-A. H period O period A period.
Yeah, exactly. Hoa.
Hoa.
Exactly. Hoa. Dear resident, your 7 a.m. around the flagpole national anthem using an Alphorn, didgeridoo, accordion, and bagpipes is in fact not appreciated by the overwhelming majority of homeowners. Please add either a harmonica or a banjo, or we will be forced to take legal action.
Wow, that's some fan mail.
I think we've got a banjo in the closet.
Call Uncle Mark. I bet you he's got one.
We need a banjo picker in the White House. Someone to pick the harmony. We need a banjo picker in the White House. Maybe someone here will vote for me.
Howdy, all of you kings, lords, and pheasants. Are you being raided by Picts on Thursdays and Huns on Saturday nights?
If so, boy, have we got the solution for you.
Introducing
Castle in a Box. A complete castle fortress complex in a box
that you and your lady can set up in an afternoon.
It comes with simple directions.
It's as easy as 1, 2, 3.
1,
you mow a big green square out on your lawn.
2,
you cut the box open with a sharp knife.
3,
you match up the colored tabs to the colored slits.
And 4,
you affix them together using the included Scottish tape. Here's a testimonial from one of our satisfied customers.
I ordered the castle in the box and set it up in one easy afternoon. I was able to keep the Viking ballet troupe at bay for 2 months until they got drapes and or tights and had to leave.
So order your box of Castle in a Box today.
Castle in a Box. Never accept substitutes.
Castle in a Box is not intended for usage in any areas with precipitation. Castle in a Box is not effective against Rat King and his horde. Castle in a Box may actually attract rodents. Do not attempt to barbecue in your backyard while using Castle in a Box. Colorblind people should not order Castle in a Box unless recommended by their doctor. Side effects may include dizziness, nausea, and not being invited to real castles. Attempting to fight fire-breathing dragons while in Castle in a Box may void warranty.
Why are there suddenly 3 people up there next to the king?
That one is the cupbearer. The second one is the scribe. The third one plays episodes of Comedy Parenting Radio.
You would not believe your eyes if 10 million fireflies lit up the world as I fell asleep.
Alrighty.
Okay, so these haven't been the best letters yet, but we did save the very best ones for last. We have a big bag of fan mail. Why don't you bring that big bag in here, Elijah? Set it down right there. Josh, just reach into the bag and go ahead and pull out any one of the letters at all. Go ahead.
This one isn't addressed to us.
Well, we can't open up that.
It's addressed to someone else.
Okay, grab another one.
Alrighty. This one is addressed to the same fellow. Okay. And so is this one. This one, too. Okay.
There, dig deep in the pile. Okay, now pull one out.
This is addressed to the same person. Are all of these addressed to the same person?
Apparently so.
Wait, you knew about this?
Well, I definitely don't go through people's mail.
Joshua, every one of these say, please forward to Comedy Parenting Radio.
What are they?
They look like they're all bills.
This guy forwarded all his bills to us.
I think it's time to get another bonfire going.
Josiah, can I have you just forward all these to Joe Rogan?
No, Joe and I have a contract.
Okay, Comedy Parenting Radio fan mail. Are there any more fan mail letters anywhere?
I don't believe so.
I'm not seeing any.
No, nothing.
I got one under the seat cushion over here.
Oh, really? Well, let's see it then.
Okay, here, take this.
Wow, this looks old. How long have you been sitting on it?
I don't know. I think it was under there for about 3 months.
We've had a fan letter for 3 months under the couch cushion? Well, open it up. We got to at least have one. To Comedy Parenting Radio, Studio B, LLC. Dear Comedy Parenting Radio, this is your final notice on the electric bill. Since we have not heard from you in several months, we will be shutting off your electricity. Ba-na-na-na, yada, 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 yada. Blah, 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 blah. Shutting off on Wednesday, June 10, 2020. Oh, we got plenty of time.
Dad?
What?
Today's Wednesday, June 10th.
It is?
Yep.
Okay, we better wrap up this show really quick, guys.
Oh, boy.
Thanks. You've been listening to Comedy Parenting Radio.
Wow. That show sounds 10 times better with just dead airspace.